Hello dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we are going to discuss about some of the very interesting concept in maths that is mainly important for the NTSC aspirants. Because solving a question is one way, but solving it in a short way, that is another technique. So we will learn how to solve the question in a very small way with the help of some trick that is very much important for the NTSC preparation. So I hope you will find this video useful. So let us now discuss two of the questions which are asked in the previous NTSC exams. So the first question, that is, if you are given x plus y plus z equal to 0, provided x, y, z are non-zero, and one thing you are given that you have to find the value of x square over yz plus y square over xz plus z square over xy. What will be that? So one way of solving the question is ki in term, if you have to solve this one, we will have to use the identity, the mainly algebraic identity. Like in term, if we take the LCM xyz, we will get in the numerator term x cube plus y cube plus z cube. And you learn about the identity that x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz, that is always equal to in terms x plus y plus z, x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. So here you are given x plus y plus z to be 0. In that case, x cube plus y cube plus z cube, that will turn out to be 3xyz. So if you substitute the value here, we get 3xyz over xyz. That means to say, answer come out to be what? 3. So generally we solve the question by this method. But sometimes we forget the identities, which identity you to use, and at the time of exam, you just get nervous and you just forget the identity used. So in case if you forget how to use this identity, we can do it in a very quick way with the help. If you are given x plus y plus z to be 0, you just put x to be 1, y to be 1 and z to be minus 2. That is satisfying this equation. So if we put x1, y1 and z minus 2, what will this expression become? It becomes 1 square over 1 into minus 2 plus 1 square over minus 2 into 1 plus minus 2 square over 1 into 1. It means to say it will become minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 plus 4. That come out to be what? 3. And you are given in the option 0, 1, 2, 3. The answer is not 0, answer is not 1, answer is not 2. The answer will be what? Option D, 3, nothing else. So, if you forget the identity, you can do it in a very quick manner by taking some of the values, nothing else. Now, let us move to the second question. To be a little bit lengthy, because in term, they have given ki A is in term of P minus Q over P plus Q, B is in term of Q minus R over Q plus R, and C in terms of R minus P over R plus P. And you have to calculate value of 1 plus A into 1 plus B into 1 minus B, 1 plus C over 1 minus A, 1 minus B, 1 minus C. So see, one way is you just put the value ABC here and you can get the answer. But if we use that method, that become quite lengthy. So using that thing, it's better. But like if you have written A in terms of P minus Q over P plus Q, we can write in term A over 1. So, if you use the component and dividend thing, we can get a plus 1 over a minus 1. That will be equal to twice of p over minus twice of q. So, that means to say p over q with a negative. So, here we can get 1 plus a over 1 minus a. That will be equal to what? P over q. In a similar manner, if in case b over 1, we write in term q minus r over q plus r. And we use the concept of component and dividend in a similar manner. We get in terms of twice of q over minus twice of r. It means to say minus q over r. So here we can get 1 plus b over 1 minus b. That will be equal to q over r. And in a similar manner, c over 1 comes out to be r minus q over r plus p. So using the component and dividend thing, we can get in terms of twice of r upon minus twice p. So from here, this we get 1 plus c over 1 minus c, that equal to r over p. So if you put the values of these three expressions here, we get what? We get in terms p over q into q over r into r over p. That will come out to be what? 1, nothing else. So if you use the method of component and dividend, we can solve the question. But it's also quite a bit lengthy method. Like we have to solve the componendo and dividendo thing, then we will get the answer. So better thing is, you don't follow this one also. We can crack this question within a second only. Like in term what? You are given ABC in term of this one. Let us take the value of PQR to be something. Like if I say, we just take P to be 1, Q to be 1 and R to be 1. Let us take all the values same. If PQR are 1, we get A in term 0, B will be 0 and C will be 0. So what does this expression become? If we put ABC to be 0, this expression become what? 1. And in the option, you are given 1 as a first option only. So we get the answer first option. Because by putting method, the options 2nd, 3rd and 4th, they will get cancelled. So if the 2nd, 3rd and 4th option are cancelled, we can get the answer only as option A, nothing else. So answer would be what? 1, nothing else. So I hope you enjoyed learning these two questions in a quick manner, how to do by the trick. So if you like the way of solving the question, do like the video, share with your friends and subscribe to our YouTube channel. So keep studying. Thank you.